What's up, everybody? My name is Scott Waters. Welcome to No Life to Metal. Gonna be doing a rock metal update. That's right, time for a rock metal update. This is a ridiculously long update. I know it's going to be because I've bought a massive amount of 7-inch singles over the past, couple months since I've done my last one, and I bought a large collection from a friend in Germany, and I bought a collection from somebody else. So there's a lot to show here. I'm going to probably do a two-parter on this one. I also have a 12-inch update coming up, and also a bootleg update coming up, but right now I'm going to get into the 7-inch stuff right away. I'm going to show them as quick as I can because there's a lot here. Like I said, it's going to be two parts. First part's going to be mostly 70s and early 80s, hard rock, new wave of British heavy metal, and that kind of thing. A little bit of pop rock from the 70s and 80s. Second part's going to be all heavy metal, thrash metal, and death metal 7-inch singles. So I'm going to start getting into this right now. So let's go. First one, this is Saxon. And this is Militia Guard with, I can't remember what's on the A side. There's actually two in this series. Backs to the Wall, Militia Guard. This is from 1980. And there was two Saxon singles released in this series with this same border, which I have the other one as well. So you got Big Teaser and Backs to the Wall. As well, there was a couple from Montrose, Van Halen, AC/DC, and Stingray all released in this series. UK singles, really cool. Like I said, I have the other Saxon one, and I believe I have the Montrose one coming up in this first pile of 7-inch singles here. So I'll have to keep my eyes open for the AC/DC ones. All right, next up, staying in the new wave of British heavy metal, this is Praying Mantis. Now, Praying Mantis were a little different from a lot of the other bands in the, The new wave of British heavy metal wasn't really a sound as much as it was a movement. So you had everybody from, Raven and Venom and Tank, with the real extreme sounds to much more melodic stuff like Def Leppard and Praying Mantis. I really like this single and I like this band, but if you're expecting something super heavy, that's not what you're going to get with this particular band. But this is All Day and All of the Night. And I think this one was from 79, 80, somewhere in that area. This is on the Arista label, and I believe this too is a UK pressing. This one is actually on the wrong sleeve. Hopefully we'll have the correct sleeve soon, waiting for one to come in the mail. But this is in the MCA sleeve. This is Tigers of Pantang. This is Hellbound, backed with Don't Give a Damn. The UK sleeve for this looks just like this one, except it's in reverse. So it's a black sleeve with white MCA all over it. This is clearly a white US pressing, as it actually says printed in the US on it. But still, cool single to have. I got this as part of the collection from my buddy in Germany, Jürgen Allman. This one here, Spider, another one of those bands, kind of falls more on the hard rock side of new wave British heavy metal. A bit of a boogie sound going on here. Not unlike maybe like a Fog Hat or I don't know. It's not super heavy, but it's really good. I enjoy Spider. Like I said, a bit of a boogie sound. So, maybe Status Quo, that's kind of the, equal as far as heaviness back in the late 70s and into the early 80s. This one was actually 1981. And then I got one here from 84 as well from Spider. I love the pictures of the band, the live photos that are come with these. There it is. You see the, there's the back. Yeah, here we go, Rock and Roll and Death Row. And this one from 81 is Feel Like a Man and All the Time. I can't pull all these out because if I do, it'll take forever. Now, this single I purchased probably 10 times. Every time I see it, I grab it. They are a new wave of British heavy metal band from the late 70s and early 80s, but this is an 85 single or 86 single. This is actually Raven. This is a promo single for the track Give Me Some Lovin', which was a Spencer Davis group song that they did a cover of. It's not a great song. I mean, not a great cover. It's just But it's Raven, and I love Raven, so anytime I see it, I grab a copy of it, and I usually give it away to somebody. This one's in really, really good shape, so I'm probably going to keep this one for myself, being that I collect anything Raven, and regardless of the fact that I'm not a big fan of this particular cover song, it's still cool to have in the collection. First wave of British heavy metal, 1974, Rockarola. Back to Never Satisfied, which is a great song. Never Satisfied was really a precursor to what, you know, Judas Priest would become. This one I also picked up in that collection from my friend Jürgen in Germany. I'm really glad he sold this one to me. This is a German pressing. As well as the next one, which is also Judas Priest, although this one is much newer, 2014 or something like that, or 19 or 18, I can't remember now. But this is Firepower. It had to be 18 or 19. 18. So 2018, Judas Priest, Firepower, backed with a live version of Breaking the Law. Man, that song, Breaking the Law, it's got to be on just like every single B-side of every single Judas Priest single ever. Recorded live at Wacken Open Air, 2015. All right. Now we're getting into some more of the 70s stuff. This is 1971. This is a promo Japanese pressing of Look at Yourself from Uriah Heep. I'm not sure if this is the correct... usually these Japanese sleeves have record company sleeves in the back. This one is just white, so I'm not sure if it's the correct sleeve. It is the correct on the bronze label. And it looks like it's, you know, it's in one of those Japanese sleeves where it's, you know, open die cut on one side, not on the other. So maybe it is. I don't know. I haven't looked into it real deeply. Like I said, this is a promo pressing. As you can see, it's got some marker written on the front of it. But I picked it up very inexpensively, so... and I'm a, you know, big Heap fan as well, so it was a no-brainer. I think it was under $5. The vinyl itself is in pristine condition, but as you can see, it's got some marker across it. So it's probably a radio station or something like that. I don't know. Next up, Scorpions and Love Drive from, what, 1979? This is would it be on the Harvest label. I think I said in past 7-inch videos that I was going to try to... remember to put years in the back on little stickers so that I wouldn't be bumbling around with the years. And I did do that on a lot of these, but not all of them again. But I remember to do it on this one. This is actually, you would think this is, looks like an early 70s single from UFO. It is not. It's actually a Polish single from 1979. And it's got Shoot Shoot and Doctor Doctor on it. Really cool picture sleeve single. And as you can see, I did put the year on there. I'm glad I did, because I would have assumed it was from like 1974, 73, which is when those songs came out. But this particular single is from 1979. So, 1979 was when UFO were really hitting their stride, you know, right around the time of Strangers in the Night and whatnot. So they were really getting big at the time. Motorhead, 1977. This is the blue edition of Motorhead, backed with City Kids. I've got a couple different, probably like five different versions of this single. I got the black picture disc version, where it's identical to this one, except instead of blue ink, it's black ink. But regardless, again, another one of those bands I just collect anything by. This one I actually picked up from a buddy of mine who lives in Albuquerque. He sold some of his collection. This is a French pressing, 1973, Alice Cooper, Hello Hooray, really cool picture sleeve edition on the Warner Brothers label. And as you can see, I can remember to put the year on the back. I'm getting better at doing that before I do these videos, but never said I was a professional, just a fan. Let me show you the back of this one, so you can kind of see the, it's got the discography on the back there. So, really cool. Another one of those, Alice, as you guys know, if you watch any of my 7-inch single videos, or any of my videos at all from the past, you know, couple weeks to the last few years, you know that I'm just a big fan of certain bands, and I collect anything by them, and Alice Cooper happens to be one of those bands, as does Motorhead and a lot of these other bands I'm showing. This one's kind of unusual. This is a Japanese pressing as well. I've never seen this version of it. I'm not exactly sure what the deal is with it. But this is Gary Moore with Philip Lynott singing. The song is Back on the Streets from the 73 or so, 74, somewhere in that area. And it's backed with this song. I can't remember the name of the song in the back. It's written on here. It's just so dark. What would you rather be, or a wasp? What Would You Rather Be or a Wasp? That's the B-side. Now, the B-side is this instrumental track that sounds a lot like something off Jeff Beck's, one of Jeff Beck's early 70s albums. Kind of has that, jazz fusion almost feel to it. Really great song. But the A-side is Back on the Streets, which is just a great track. I mean, it could have been a Thin Lizzy song. And, of course, like I said, it's got Philip Lynott singing on it. So what's unusual about it, it is on the MCA label, so I'm pretty sure that this is not the correct, sleeve. I'm even not even sure about this front sleeve. I've seen this before, and it's always been like a purple color. This one here is black, so this little border you see here, the ones I've seen in the past have always been purple. So I just don't know what the deal is with this one. I mean, it is a Japanese pressing. It is the original MCA sleeve, but it's got this, insert into it. I just don't know what the deal is, because, like I said, it's not the correct, definitely not the correct inner sleeve. At least I don't think it is. But again, I've never seen one with a black border. All the ones I've ever seen in the past have been purple. So regardless, I didn't have any of them, so I grabbed this one. It wasn't real expensive, so glad to have it in the collection. Philip Lynott with Gary Moore, Back on the Streets. Okay, this one I showed in the past video, a BCLT video. This is Jimi Hendrix All Along the Watchtower, 1967, I think. But it was in a white sleeve, and I desperately looked for the original record company sleeve, and I found one, so that's why I'm showing it again. It has the original Warner reprise sleeve now. Another one of those guys, bands that, Jimi Hendrix collect anything by. All right, this one kind of jumping into the 80s here, but this is from the second Ace Frehley's Comet album. It's Over Now. This is just a great single, and it's got an instrumental B-side called The Acorn Is Spinning. Ace Frehley, obviously, being from Kiss. Oh, and here's that Montrose single I talked about earlier. It's his Bad Motor Scooter, backed with I Don't Want It. Again, a UK single, and as you can see, it's got a similar back to the saxophone I showed earlier, and it's got the big giant number on it, so you can see it's part of that series. There's four AC/DC ones. I don't have any of those. There is a couple Van Halen, a couple Montrose, and Stingray. So I'm going to just keep an eye out for these, because, like I said, I got the Saxon ones, and I just got them because they're Saxon, but now I kind of want the whole series. Another one is an 80s, just one that I hadn't seen before. David Lee Roth, That's Life, U.S. pressing, original picture sleeve single. Another 80s one. This is Jafria, of course, Greg Jafria, who, when Angel parted ways in the early 80s, he formed the band Jafria, which eventually became House of Lords. Jafria and House of Lords, basically the same band, but Gene Simmons signed Jafria to his label and made them change their name to House of Lords. So, but regardless, this is a cool single. I've just never seen a single for the second Jafria before. Call to Heart and Out of the Blue. And I didn't put the year on this one. Let's see if I can see it on here. 1984, and I believe this is also a UK pressing. And here's a big shocker. You don't see a 7-inch update from me without showing at least one single from this band. Well, this time I'm going to throw three. So, Aerosmith, Dream On, Japanese pressing, one of the Japanese pressings I was missing. This is actually a 1976 pressing. Now, 1973 is when Dream On came out, and there are some 73 singles for that song. But in 75, 76, the song took off on the radio again and became a hit. So there was a lot of pressings of Dream On in 76. This happens to have, I believe, Mama Kin on the B-side. So, and as you can see, I did put the year on there so I wouldn't forget again. And as well, this is one also from 76. This is a Holland pressing. And this, I believe, has Somebody on the B-side. So Dream On with Somebody. It's hot in here. I'm turning the air on. It makes a lot of noise, but it is what it is. All right. Back to it. I'm just sweating. I keep pulling my hair back because I'm just hot in here. It's summertime. What do you expect? All right. Next up, we've got the Columbia Hall of Fame single. It's a jukebox single for Come Together and Walk This Way. Two hits on the same single. So, thus the Hall of Fame, and it even has a little jukebox slip with it, which is cool. So, again, just one I didn't have. I mean, I probably have 100 Aerosmith singles now, but I still keep finding ones I don't have, so. 1971, German single for Deep Purple's Fireball, picture sleeve, very cool. Backed with Demon's Eye on the Harvest label. Thing with Richie Blackmore, this is Rainbow Long Live Rock and Roll, backed with Sensitive to Light. Oops. This is actually odd because it's a 1981 pressing. So this is when Dio was in Sabbath, and I don't know why this, all of a sudden this single became popular again, and he ended up putting out a UK pressing of this single. Cool though, I've never seen a picture sleeve single of the for this particular album, and I've always loved the album cover for this one with the line art drawing of the band. One more from Rainbow here. This is I Surrender, backed with, I never can pronounce this other track. I'm always jacked this track up because it's not English, and I don't speak any other language. So the B-side is Yelish Das Mascha. I don't know. Here you go. Pause the video and look for yourself, because I can't pronounce it. So anyhow, another Japanese single. I picked both of those up from the same seller, where I pick up a lot of these Japanese singles from. And they're always pretty inexpensive. I mean, never, you know, very rarely do I ever see any over $10. So, and he's a U.S. seller, so the shipping's usually $4. So. Pretty cool to get Japanese singles for that price around here. Okay, this is cool. This is a pre-release for the first Pat Travers album. This is the Pat Travers band, Makes No Difference. It's a little unusual. It's got as you can see, it's in a, you know, your normal thing, but it's normal sleeve, but it's not actually a vinyl single. It's a flexi. Single-sided with one track. But yeah, I mean, that's, again, Pat Travers, one of those guys, Canadian guitar player that I collect anything from, and was glad to finally, I've actually been looking for this one for quite a while, to find this pre-release single from the early 70s. So Pat Travers band, Makes No Difference. I'll put that away later. Staying on Pat Travers Band, this is from 1979. This is a UK pressing of, live pressing of Boom Boom Out Goes the Lights. Backed with something else. I always try and put the single in so that I can read the B-side off of the label, but of course I didn't do that on this one. Starborough Blues. Since I have it out, I might as well show you there's the back. So obviously a single for the Go For What You Know live album. And then one more from Pat Travers. This is actually his brand new 2022 single. Just came out. Full length album's not even out yet, but this is Push Yourself. And it's actually, you know, a very good song. I was kind of expecting something bluesy, but it's just straightforward hard rock. Full spectrum on the B-side. There's the back. It is on a red vinyl. There's the center label. So, like I said, brand new 2022 from Pat Travers. Okay, how we doing here? 20 minutes in, I still got a lot to go. All right, I'm gonna go quicker. Cheap Trick. This is Dream Police, backed with Heaven Tonight. And I don't remember what pressing this is. It doesn't make a difference. I got two different pressings here. This is a Spain pressing with, again, Dream Police and El Cielo Esta Noche. Backed with Suena Con Policias. So, Heaven Tonight, obviously, backed with, well, Dream Police. So, two different pressings of that. Again, another one of those bands I collect anything by. A huge Cheap Trick fan. Here's one I didn't even know existed, but it's kind of cool. This is from the early 80s. This is Oh Boy Demo and If You Want My Love Demo. So two demo tracks on a single from, I believe this is 81 or 82. If You Want My Love demo, which is a pretty popular song from them. Okay, keeping up. This is a promo single from Canada from Canadian guitar player Frank Marino. This is for Strange Dreams, which is one of my all-time favorite songs from him. Just don't see Frank Marino singles ever, so really cool to find a promotional single. It actually says right on here, DJ use only, not for sale. And it's in the original Canadian CBS sleeve. Another band you see almost every time I do a thing. This is Ted Nugent. This is a UK pressing of Death by Misadventure and Homebound. And I believe Homebound is the A side, obviously. There's a big giant A on the front of it there. And one more from the Nuge. This is Damn Yankees, Don't Tread on Me. Spain promo pressing, picture sleeve. And it's, I believe it's the same song on both sides. Of course, I can't read most of it because it's in Spanish. But it does say promotional... No, it says it in Spanish, so I can't read it. But yeah, it's got the same song on both sides, so you can kind of see the back there. Finding anything from the second Damn Yankees album on vinyl is pretty rare, including that particular album. I'd love to find that album on vinyl, but really very hard to find. Anyhow, this is Grand Funk, People That Stopped the War. This is an Italian pressing, 1971, from the E Pluribus Funk album, backed with... Save the Land. Alright, now we're getting into some lighter weight stuff here before I get into the heavier stuff. So, this is Kansas, Reason to Be, promo single. So you've got the stereo and mono versions on both sides from Kansas. I've shown stuff from this band before, way outside the hard rock heavy metal spectrum, but this is Dave Clark 5, 1969. This is Dave Clark 5 playing a melody of old classics tracks. So you've got, oops, didn't come out of there correctly. Let me put it back in the sleeve here. Okay, so you've got, on the A side, you've got Sweet Little 16, Long Tall Sally, Chantilly Lace, Whole Lot of Shaking Going On, Blue Suede Shoes and Lucille, and then you've got Reelin' and Rockin' and Memphis, Tennessee. So basically, you've got the Dave Clark 5 playing a bunch of classic rock songs, and this being from 1969. And this one is even further outside the hard rock and heavy metal spectrum, but this is The Knack. And I love this song, and I actually like The Knack, but this is My Sharona. I mean, if people know that song, you've heard the hook a million times on the radio, but the song actually has a great jam section in the middle of it. So My Sharona and kind of that 80s new wave stuff, which is what this is too. This is Gary Numan and Cars, backed with Asylum from Pleasure Principle, Japanese pressing. One of my all-time favorite bands, Genesis. This is a UK pressing of Man in the Corner in the original Christmas sleeve, and I've never actually seen one of these Christmas sleeves before, so it's kind of cool to find this. Backed with Submarine. Submarine is a instrumental track. Tony Banks instrumental track, and it was a non-album track from that album, which, what was that? Man in the Corner, that's Duke, right? Two singles from Peter Gabriel, same song. Once again, I got the U.S. pressing and two different pressings. slightly different covers, one being on the Mercury label, one being on the Charisma label. I think one of them is a Spain single, and the other one is I think it's a U.S. single. But if I'm not mistaken, there's two different B-side tracks. Let me double-check that. It's been a while since I played this one. Lead a Normal Life is the B-side on this one. You can see the back. I think actually the other one's Lead a Normal Life, too, now that I think about it. But let's just double-check it. Nope, I am right. I am correct. Games Without Frontiers... backed with The Star I Don't Remember on the B-side. So yeah, it is. I was correct. There is two different B-side tracks on those. And one more from Peter Gabriel. This is U.S. pressing a Sledgehammer. And backed with Don't Break the Rhythm. Three more to go before I get into the heavy stuff. And I split the video. So this is ZZ Top, Japanese pressing of Sleeping Bag. picked this from the same seller. I picked a lot of these Japanese pressings from inexpensively, and this is Party on the Patio on the B side. And then we got one, two left from pretty much the same band. This is Yes, Into the Lens. This is, 1980. And this is one of the few, you know, older Yes albums to not feature John Anderson on vocals. From the drama album, you can see the back. This being a, where was this thing pressed at? This is Spain pressing on the Atlantic label. Backed with Does It Really Happen? And then, the last one in this first batch, Anderson, Bruford, Wakeman, and Howe. Basically, Yes without the Yes moniker. I mean, it's got the Yes look, it's got the Yes sound, but it didn't have Chris Squire, therefore it wasn't Yes. Oddly enough, Yes is out there touring now without Chris Squire or John Anderson, but back here, Yes, Chris Squire owned the name, and he wasn't playing on this, so Anderson, Bruford, Wakeman, Howe. And what do we have here? We have Order of the Universe backed with Fist of Fire. Okay, so there you go. That's it for this one. I'm going to get right into part two right now, but for this part, I'll just say thanks for watching. God bless. Stay strong.